The two gentlemen who tried to extort congressman and car salesman who thinks he's the funny one on the lot, Matt Gaetz, said the $25 million would be used to bring back kidnapped and presumed dead FBI agent Bob Levinson. The Washington Examiner came correct with receipts revealing a blackmail document saying authorities had compromising photos depicting Congressman Gaetz and an election official involved in a sexual orgy with underage prostitutes. There are so many twists and turns in this story, I cannot express to you how little I've thought about the victims here. It's just like, wow, Matt Gaetz is going off and I cannot stop watching. Now, Kara, do you think the blackmailers invented this ruse because they evaluated Matt Gaetz's intelligence and decided he'd most likely fall for a story a child would make up after eating too much candy?
Yes. This is really kind of a crazy story. I don't even understand it. I know you're innocent until proven guilty, but in this case, it's so crazy. I can't even understand what's happening.
I can't help but think of who will take care of Nestor when Matt goes to jail. Oh my God, should I adopt him? You guys, this could be my chance to be a mom.
Kylie, you should.
Okay.
The most loving families are born from government sex scandals / international hostage rescue extortion grifts.
You know, people keep acting like it's bad when men groom teenagers, but I wouldn't be the woman I am today. Unable to trust any man I meet, a complete lapdog to a megalomaniac white woman, if I hadn't met Jeremy.
Mm-hmm, that's right. Now, moving on. After years of throwing people in jail for possession of marijuana, Governor Cuomo was finally convinced to legalize it by his constituents' incessant calls for him to stop sexually harassing women. Quote, lawmakers and lobbyists were surprised by the number of concessions that Mr. Cuomo, not known for easily compromising, made in order to secure a policy win amid a worsening political crisis. It's kind of sad that people need to smoke to feel relaxed. All I need to unwind is to have four people compliment me round robin style for an hour or two. Now, Kara, is this law a sign that racial equity is no longer an afterthought, but the first thought when your political image needs a makeover?
Well, it's interesting. It's interesting. I think it's probably more for the fact that if you're high, you might not notice the incessant groping.
Wow, work.
It's not all good news. This will disproportionately hurt people like me who are nonviolent private prison investors.
Now, moving on to the latest in the trial of Derek Chauvin for the murder of George Floyd. Here's Chauvin's defense attorney offering a masterclass in discrediting witnesses for being rude during a murder.
Do you recall saying, I dare you to touch me like that. I swear I'll slap the out of both of you.
Yeah, I did. I meant it.
Right. So again, sir, it's fair to say that you grew angrier and angrier.
No, I grew professional and professional. I stayed in my body. You can't pay me out to be angry.
Okay, this is actually a classic defense move. Asking jurors to imagine the utter terror of being a white police officer surrounded by black people begging you to stop murdering. Now, Kara, this trial is flush with video evidence from security cameras, body cams, and phones. If we don't see justice for George Floyd, does this mean that we can't rely solely on Silicon Valley tech bros to solve racism?
That's an interesting question. I mean, it just seems like the videos don't even matter, right? All these people are getting off despite clear video evidence. So that's kind of an interesting thing. But no, Silicon Valley is not here to solve your problems. It's here to create them, really.
The beauty of America as this melting pot of diversity is the fact that the group of people being oppressed in this country grows larger every day. It's fun for the whole family.
Yes, I love that.
It's inclusive.
It's so inclusive. Now, moving on. Stand back, everyone. I got this. It's time for your signal boost. Republicans in Georgia have absolutely haterated election access, passing a draconian, Malfoynian voting law that disenfranchises black voters. In response, Georgia-based companies Delta and Coca-Cola spoke out, and Major League Baseball is considering moving its All-Star game from Atlanta. Here's President Biden stepping up to the plate, or I think that's what it's called. I only read and row.
Today's professional athletes are acting incredibly responsibly. I would strongly support them doing that.
It's not the first time corporations have a death dropped where our government flopped. Bank of America stopped North Carolina from passing anti-trans legislation, and the NCAA stopped South Dakota from doing the same. It made me realize, to redress our grievances, why do we turn to government when corporations get shit done, y'all. Congresspeople are just middlemen between you and the corporations in charge, so speak to the real manager, the guy who owns a horizon-wide distribution center in your congressperson's district. Or spend less time in the voting booth and more time doing the work, creating a corporate behemoth with insidious influence in every facet of American life to make positive change. Because corporations always have our best interests in mind and are not just doing the least possible to preserve their consumer base. Skeptical Drake face to democracy and a happy Drake point to corporatocracy. And that's your signal boost.